What's going on, YouTube? Today I want to talk about astrophotography dithering and how it's a great noise removal technique. A couple of nights ago, I did a live stream, and during the live stream, I captured several photos of the Horsehead Nebula. Some of those photos I dithered, and some of them I did not. Today, I'm going to stack those photos with no other calibration, so no dark frames, no bias, no flat, just the subs with and without dithering, to compare how the noise removal works when you dither. I'm going to be using PixInsight, so let's switch over to the workspace now. Okay, so you can see my PixInsight loaded up, and the first thing that I need to do is a star alignment. I'm going to start with the non-dithered images I captured during a live stacking session with the SkyX. First thing I want to do is set the output directory. Now, I have to add some files. And for the purposes of this exercise, I'm just going to randomly select one of the non-dithered images as the reference image. We'll go ahead and apply global, and I'll let this run in real time so you can see how fast a 16-core, 32-thread Threadripper can align 15 images. You might be able to hear how loud my Threadripper gets too. I'm air cooling it, I don't have a water cooler for it yet. Those are aligned. Go ahead and reset all of the settings, and we're gonna do the same process with my dithered images. So once again, we're going to pick 15 images, set an output directory. To arbitrarily pick just some random dithered image as the reference image, apply global, and about another 20 seconds or so, it'll have those 15 frames aligned. All right. So now I've got two stacks of images aligned. One is dithered, the other is undithered. So I want to do image integration. Add files, and let's start with the undithered. Pick those 15. Average combination, no normalization, no weight. Pixel rejection 1. Windsorized, no normalization. Just leave all of that alone for right now. This time we're going to do my dithered, aligned, open. No other settings change, so I can just apply global. Oh wow, you can definitely see what the dithering did here. So now that I've got my two files saved, we can apply some histogram stretching. I'm going to try my best to do the exact same stretch on both of them. Alright, so now that I've got my histogram transformation open, click on integration, which is the undithered image. Bring up our real-time preview. Drag the slider over to bring that spike of the histogram as close to the center as I can get it. And apply. Close the real-time preview, bring this up, reopen real-time preview, and apply. Okay, now reset everything. Close a real-time preview, and in this integration. One is very close to halfway between the middle and that dotted line. There. Go ahead and apply that. And now the histogram for integration and integration one. Still need a little bit more stretch on this one. Maybe to about there. So we'll reset. The spikes are pretty much even between this one and this one. And you can see the sky backgrounds are pretty close to even. So now we're going to lower the background. Bring up that real-time preview again. And again, the backgrounds are looking pretty even. Let's take a look at these two as they are right now. So right off the bat, I'm gonna examine this part right here, the Flame Nebula. This is the dithered image, and the Flame Nebula is pretty smooth. On the undithered image, the Flame Nebula and the surrounding space has got a lot of noise and a lot of grain happening. And the dithering smoothed that background out because it had quite a bit of motion. We saw in the pixel rejection map that there's a lot on this border that I would have to crop off because the frames basically were stacked like this. It marched the frames around during the dithering process. And then the star alignment put all the details right back on top of one another, but the noise gets averaged out even with just 15 images. If I wanted to zoom in a little bit more, you can see that there's quite a few cold pixels in here, but not many in the way of hot pixels, and there's some pretty good detail on the horse's head. Here, all those hot pixels remain, and the horse's head is, it's not as well defined as it is over here. I could probably take that a step further with some more histogram adjustments and really bring out some of the detail, but this is by far a much more clean image. And the only thing I did to this was I just dithered the subexposure. I didn't take any darks, I didn't do any bias frames, no flat frame calibration, and it was able to very well control the noise just through dithering alone. So I hope that this quick exercise shows the benefits of dithering and why you should definitely be adding this to your toolkit. If you've got an autoguider, by far the best thing you can do with that autoguider beyond guiding is to then start dithering your images. The guiding is going to keep your stars circular, and the dithering is going to get the noise down. So I hope this was a quick and very informative tutorial for you, and I hope to see you in the next one.